Welcome everyone to episode 1 of a Road to Redemption FIFA 19 Career Mode series. My name is Freestyle, and this will be my first try at making a YouTube series for FIFA Career Mode. I look forward to working through this together with you all and hope to provide an entertaining and engaging career mode for everyone to enjoy. At this point, we're going to take Arsenal FC, and we're going to remove all their best players, keeping just the youth academy, or just their youth players, and any players that came from the youth academy, I'm going to try and keep. I've got a list of all the players that Arsenal currently have out on loan. I got to put them back all on their teams, and then for most of them, I'll just reassign them that team for good. And then I'll keep some of the, again, I'll keep their youth players. I'll keep their young guys. I'm going to try and keep anybody that's 70 and under. I think there's two guys that might be above 70, which is Reece Nelson and Ainsley Maitland-Niles. I'm not 100% sure what I want to do with those guys yet. So let's go. Here's the fun part. So, as I mentioned, I'm just going through the roster, first recalling all of the loaned out players so that I have a complete list, and then I'll start reassigning players to realistic teams, such as Aubameyang going to PSG, Alexander Lacazette going to Atletico Madrid, etc. Loaned players like David Ospina will go back to the team that had them, which in this case is Napoli, with the aim being to keep all youth players rated 70 and under. The only exception I made was for Reece Nelson and Ainsley Maitland-Niles, as I just like these two players and felt like keeping them. The new ownership who have taken over this once proud club, who have been tarnished by the shadiness, are looking for a new manager, are signing a new manager, who follows their new values of building from within, building with locally grown talent. What a weird way to say that. Mainly talent from the United Kingdom, England, Scotland, Ireland, I think are the countries I can scout in FIFA 19. And they're going to kind of go on a limb and get a young up-and-comer coach from the football powerhouse, Canada. So here we go. We're going to do this Arsenal team. First things first, we're going to swap them with, we're going to demote them into the championship, and we're going to swap them with Aston Villa. Now, the reason I chose the championship over any of the other one is that in the championship, they will be the worst team, basically. Two stars is lower than most everybody else. Everyone else is like two and a half stars and up. In League One, they will be still one of the stronger teams. I think I would just mop through League One. So I think Championship makes it that much more challenging. So it'd be cool to drop them all the way to League Two, but I've done a League Two to Premier League climb, and honestly, by the fifth season, my team is strong enough to, I just did this more comp where I won the treble. So it allows me to progress nice and slow and build a strong team by the time I hit the Premier League, where I think here, this team will be weak enough and require me to really try to get proper youth academy going, and hopefully will still be difficult. So they're going to be promoted or demoted to the championship. I'm going to promote Aston Villa. A, I like them. B, they're currently in the Premier League and they got promoted that season. So let's do it. I think it was that season. Anyways, and here we go, building the great Canadian coach Maximilian Trudeau, again from the proud soccer / football, you can tell I'm Canadian powerhouse. FIFA 19 had the worst faces. This one's my favorite for some reason. This one looks younger, doesn't he? Remember that one? What's a Maxim? This guy's Maximilian. Canadian football genius who's gonna revive the once proud, slightly tarnished Arsenal club. Let's do this. The official story is that after an intense investigation, the English FA has found the previous owners of Arsenal FC to have committed many infractions with financial fair play and internal corruption. The team has been demoted to the championship and has a two-year transfer ban, two-year European Cup tournament ban, and a two-year domestic cup tournament ban. The new ownership has come in and is adamant to never be punished in this way again. So they have hired a young coach from the football powerhouse of Canada named Maximilian Trudeau. And their goal now is to build a team using local talent, youth academy only, limiting any signings from the free agent pool or transfer market. Only exception they're making when it comes to free agent purchases is things such as injuries and whatnot. That's the story I came up with. The idea comes from a Reddit user whom I cannot remember their username, and I apologize. So I decided, let's do it with Arsenal. Let's have some fun. I'll be playing using the ultimate difficulty in this save and without any sliders. I'll be using 6-minute halves, disabling the European competition for a season, as well as disabling the first transfer window. Being a new coach, we're going to bring in a whole new formation. You know what? Let's make it interesting. Let's do a 4-3-3 attack. So Nketiah will start there. Bukayo Saka. Like this kid. And then Reese Nelson. He's a 4-star first. That was one of the reasons why I wasn't sure about keeping this kid. He's a 4-star weak foot and skill move. Matt Macy's going to be starter. Smith Rowe can play cam. Bielik is a CDM. And then Maitland-Niles will be the guy on this side. He's right foot as well. Okay. So we'll do this. I like my guys to be a little bit more spread out and make him a left CM. And then Carl Jenkins is going to start at right back. Zulo, Mavropanos, Bramall as my starting defense. I think that's kind of what I want, but let's see. Oh, there's Joel Willock. So Joel Willock's definitely going to be one of my guys that comes in. Gilmore is going to be another one. Fjornsson. I like this. He's going to be a guy that's going to come in. Medley, 6'5", low, high. See, that leaves me very little in terms of bench. If somebody gets injured, I'm going to get screwed. That'll be my starters. These three will be my regular rotation guys. Tactics. Press after loss. After I don't like that. I don't want, because my team doesn't have much players, so I don't want them to get tired. I'll do pressure on heavy touch. Width, I'll keep it pretty much in the middle. Depth, I'll keep it middle. Or, you know what, let's be a high-pressing team. Offensive style possession, I like balanced. That's good enough for me. Width, I like my team to play wide offensively. Players in the box, I like my players to get up in there. Corners, three is fine. Free kicks, I like everybody out of there. Because on free kicks, I'm either shooting or just passing. I never actually cross the ball in, so keep him out of there. Instructions. So he's a high, so you're definitely coming back on defense. Balance width. I like to stay wide. I'm going to keep this as balanced support. Nketiah, we want you to stay central, get it behind. Okay, Smith Rowe, come back on defense. I want you to get in the box. I want you to stay central. Bielik will leave as balance attack. Him being a central defensive midfielder by trait, we want him to be the last guy on defense. Stick to position and default. We're going to do cover wing because we're going to bomb our left and right back up. So we need somebody covering the wing. Maitland-Niles is the guy that's going to get forward. He's going to be my box-to-box midfielder. Jenkinson, I want you to attack, and I like overlap. Bramall, same thing. Roles. Who's going to be the captain? I think Carl Jenkins has got to be the captain. Longest serving player. Free kicks. 67. I guess Nelson is doing all my free kicks. Penalties will be taken by Nketiah. Corners will be Nelson and Saka. Team is set up the way we want it to be set up. Training. Defense and goalie are the most important things for me in terms of training, so that's who we're going to train up. So that's what we'll do for training for now. And the last thing we will work on, we'll get our scouts. So physically strong, defensive-minded, stick in the United Kingdom. I'm going to try to do United Kingdom as much as possible. I'm always curious about the free agent market when you start with all the game-generated characters. So, like, there's a couple here. Let's see. I'm only scouting them and checking them out just to see what they are. I'm almost positive the winger is going to have a 4-star skill move. That seems to happen a lot. Oh, no. 3-star skill move, 4-star weak foot, can play cam. Yeah, it's usually, I have this generative feed, medium low. Huh? Alexander Mann, medium, 4-star weak foot, 6-foot tall Austrian striker. Pretty neat. Left back, center back, 5'10", medium, 2 skill, not bad. And then a 6'4", center back, low, medium. What's that trait? He's got a trait, long shot taker. All right, here we go. I'm going to skip. I'm going to stop on the first so that I get my first scouting report. And I got a game and coming up, Hull. And then here's the Carbo Cup. Training injury. Are you serious? 2 months. Carl Jenkinson. You got to be kidding me. You got to be kidding me. Oh, that sucks. I guess in one regard we have at least Maitland Niles who can play right wing. So what we'll do is we'll put him here. We'll start Willick. He'll be the captain. So because I need players, I'm going to try and sign anybody who is ready to start. Like 90,000, his overall is not going to be that great. 70, his overall is going to be terrible. 88, not bad. And he's a goalkeeper, isn't he? Yep. And he's 6'4". That's actually... We're going to sign that player because that's not that bad. So, here we are. We're on the first day of August. We've got Hull City, Wigan, and Ipswich Town coming up. We're going to forfeit this game because it's a Carbo Cup game and we have a domestic ban. Here we go. Hull City away. First game on the road to redemption for Arsenal FC.
To the KCOM Stadium. Alan Smith is with me and I'm Martin Tyler.
Here we go. Look at Matt Mason. Man, he is huge. Is he like 6'4", 6'5"? And here we go. Road to redemption begins. Putting on a little bit of pressure and the steal. There we go. That's a good start. To Bielik. There goes Emil Smith-Rowe. Swing out. Come on, get there. All right. Reece Nelson. Let's cross that baby in. Clear. Good clearance. Maitland-Niles. And a shot way wide. I'm assuming he's right-footed because that was a terrible shot. Look at that. What is he looking at? Oh boy, Irvine, nice defense. Oh, they're putting pressure on. Oh no, this is not good. Oh no, where's my winger? Where's my left back? Where is he going? Why are you so far? What a terrible clearance.
High up the pitch. He's cut it back, looking for a teammate.
Great save. Terrible clearance. I hate that the team runs so far up the field. First corner defense, here we go. That's a nice one. Great clearance.
Good defending.
Go, buddy. Go, Reece Nelson. Let's see if he wins that out. He does.
Nelson.
And fires away.
The shot gets blocked.
What a block.
Forward,
good through pass to Reece Nelson. Puts the cross in. Bukayo Saka. Oh, great clearance. Great control here. We got to keep the pressure up. Hull City's got to get tired at some point, you'd assume. Oh.
Arsenal, give it away.
Held on to it for too long. Oh,
got a free kick.
I got a free kick. That is a rarity. Let's see what we can do here. Let's back up. Let's see if we can get that knuckleballer in there. Oh, that was a terrible free kick. I tried to do the knuckleball and I failed miserably. Wow. Oh God, oh God. Put on some pressure. Get out there, put some pressure on. Oh, come on. Look, since when can't you just kick a dude in the hip and knock him to the ground and miss the ball completely? Oh boy, that was a good pass. No! Oh, what a save by Macy. Willick to Emil Smith-Rowe. Here comes Bielik. What a pass. Terrible shot.
Tried to find the winning ticket in the raffle.
Terrible shot.
Number short. Yes. He took it early. Stewart. He's looking for
putting on some defensive pressure. Terrible cross. Allows us to clear it. Terrible pass. Did not mean to kick it that far up the field.
But they have got the ball, and that, I suppose, is a threat.
Oh, no, that's a good move. And goal.
And they've scored. That's the first goal.
That was some great passing. That was some great passing. And they got me.
Well, they're going.
I'm keeping the rage inside right now. Good pressure by Bukayo Saka. Just missed the interception. Hull City looking to get one more before the half.
I think the wide man's got a chance here. There's space out near the touchline. Well, he has got a chance to get the cross in.
Looks like they just ran out the clock. So not a very good first half.
Off the pass.
Let's see if we can get some pressure on the ball and win it back quickly.
Comes in with a tackle.
Good tackle, but quick into the tackle. Hull City keeps the ball.
And the result is going to be a throw.
Bukayo Saka just kicked a Hull City player in the head and did not get fined for it. So that's good. Let's go, boys. That was a terrible pass.
Going to be a throw.
At least you can count on Hull City to make mistakes, because I have not been making good choices on offense, I can tell you that much. A nice little 1-2.
Well, here comes
too far. Oh, I got lucky there. Great clearance. I had two guys in the box and neither one could get to the ball.
Hull City making a change here.
Christian Bielik making a run.
Maybe the counter-attack is on here.
Enketia to Emil Smith Rowe.
Pulls it back now.
Enketia.
Yeah, definitely should be.
Had an opportunity of a lifetime and misses the net. What is going on here, folks?
And it's
there's Willick wide open.
Very good football here. We've still got
here's a nice little give and go.
Sure,
Enketia gets
well
through. And fires one off the post. Come on.
The ball's loose.
I thought that was in. I completely started celebrating before the ball got in. And now I look like a fool.
Still thinking of
to Bielik. Maitland-Niles makes his run down.
Plenty of width for the team to attack into.
Emil Smith Rowe. Top draw, boys. Top draw. Great pass. Don't understand a 360 no scope, but I'll take it. And Arsenal get their first goal of the year and level it up. Great control and top in.
A good look here again by the replay.
What a great goal. Almost missed the net completely yet again. To Aries, to Fjornensen. Swings it out to Reese Nelson. Back to Fjornensen. To Aries. Bad first touch. Arias. That's how you say that name. Arias. Great passing by Hull City.
Working hard just to see maybe a sight of goal.
Oh, what great passing by Hull City. This is not looking good. Oh, what a move. Just leaves him for dead. Great header. Thank God for the crossbar.
I think the goal will soon.
Fjornensen makes a great run. Great defense by Hull City. I took too long. Great recovery by Arsenal. Swing it wide. Oh, that was dangerous. That was a dangerous and some would say stupid pass. Oh, and Enketia with the strip, with the steal, with the cross. Hits the defender right in front of him. Great cross. Move down the wing. Oh, my God. I mean, thank God for terrible, terrible shooting by Hull City. A crossbar and a free header. Wow. I mean, I deserve to lose this game. And the referee blows his whistle. Arsenal pull out a draw, which they probably do not deserve.
Whew,
that was a tough game.
You hope that that leads to winning the first.
Man, Macy is huge. So here's the thing. I think I'm going to end this video here. Although it's only one game of action, this is more of a kind of an introductory video to the season. We'll try to do about three games per video, keep it in the 10-minute mark. I hope you enjoyed this first episode. Hopefully I'll make these videos as interesting as possible to keep you all coming back. And I'm open to suggestions. If there's any kind of rules you think I should put in place, if you think the FA Cup and Carabao Cup domestic ban is a bad idea or a good idea, let me know your thoughts. If there's any financial limitations you think I should put on myself, like the wage bill salary cap that I've kind of imposed of 200,000, just based on what the current team's wages is, but I think it's 178,000. So I said, figure 200,000 is a good cap. But let me know what you think. I look forward to your thoughts, and hopefully you enjoy this video and you come back for episode 2. Until then, this is Freestyle signing off.